Hey everybody, Basket here. Welcome back to Factorio. I've been busy. That's usually how I start these things. I've expanded out. I think this a bit more down here, and then also over here. Expanded out, secured a bunch more resources, been mining those up, and so on. So what I want to show you now, before I actually get it all hooked up, is my new science thing. So previously in here, I had like a whole line of sort of randomly scattered things. Now I have, so this is the blue one. So if we zoom in a little bit. So here I'm making, in this pod right here, I'm making red science, making green science, blue science, purple science. This one I'm actually just flying in the resources, so there's no materials drop. And then I have research one, research two. So this is my four different things drop-offs template. And I'm actually have this extra little cannon thing here. But anyway, so this one is actually the slowest one because of both plastic and or red chips. Is a little bit slow. I guess it's just really just the red chips. Anyway, so I don't have as much, but now I have a train. Okay, I guess I have quite a bit stocked up, but I have one train set up for carrying these two, and then one train set up for green and red. So, oh god. Okay, well that's fun. Hold on. All right, where was I? okay, kill me again. Let's go this way. And so if I run down here, to research one, we will plug research one into the whole thing. So let's run down there real quick. I don't technically run down there, but I'll do it anyway. So this is where it's the same template where I construct stuff. So actually I still have these long arm inserters here and this back belt. Actually the back belt's needed, but I have long arm inserters even though they're not really needed. But the idea is the train comes in, can drop off four different types of resources, which is what we want, and then put them on the proper belts. So each of these belts will on either side will have one of the resources, one of the different types of things. So research one. So what we want to do is, I have a lot of trains. So we want to locate the one that's associated with green science. So we want green science pickup, green science, or red science pickup. So we can just tell this guy, I want you to now also go to research one for a little bit, and then also go to research two for a little bit. So that'll have them drop off for 30 seconds or until they're inactive. And I'll go ahead and wait until they arrive so we can see what that looks like. Because once it gets to the second one, which is, I'll be down there in a second, it might not really, actually, so I guess I can also do the next one. Blue science, pick up and drop off. Okay, so here we want to do research one. Oops, sorry. So right now it's empty. I can't see it. It's behind us. Research two. Okay, there we go. So now we can see. So one of the cars is for red. One of them is for green. It comes in here, dumps that all in, and then ends up on one of the belts. These are grabbing it. Right now I'm researching this, so we'll have to wait until the next train comes in, which is, it's here now. So this is about to empty out. It'll go until, for a little while. These are fast inserters. Yeah, these are stack inserters. So it's already as sort of optimal as it can be. So now the next guy comes in, he will start emptying out. And this one probably is full, yeah. I have quite a bit of the science, the alien science stuff. So here comes the blue. Those will be grabbed into those, and these will start researching stuff. Shortly, maybe. Oh, I guess this one doesn't require, interesting. This one doesn't actually require the purple science, so it's not grabbing any of those. Now we're out of power. All right, let's go run down here to check out the next research two. We can see how that's looking. So the other train isn't quite here yet. But you can see it comes over here and drops off the stuff. So if I wanted to research faster, or if I had like a surplus of the science stuff, I could make more of these. I could make a research three, make the trains automatically drop off the stuff, and now I'm researching even more. And really with this template, if I don't have the pickup spot, like I do, so here's create, drop off stuff, create things, pick up. So if I don't have the pickup, I can actually have this thing mirrored on the other side. But I don't have that set up, so I'm not too worried about it. But because I have a lot of space. So if you look, like a lot of these different throughways aren't really, there's nothing really in a lot of them. It's mainly just to expand, and then I have like a big ore productions thing here. And then over here, I was working on a big one. Where is it? Here it is. So this one was a little complicated because in all of my intersections, there was copper or a lot of iron. And so I had to sort of be creative with some of these paths. But I got it all worked out. And so now I'm mining up that stuff. I'm probably going to ignore that copper, or the ore rather. Coal. One thing I did want to find, I want to get the science up and running. Because I want to find a more effective way of killing the bad guys. Tanks are working out pretty well, but I want something a little bit better. There we go. So actually now I finished researching. Cool. So now that we are here, let's take a look. So I could start working on some of the armor. Flamethrowers, I don't know. Let's see, power armor. I guess perhaps equipping up myself with better armor is a way to go. So let's work on the power armor. In fact, right now, I think actually my armor broke, so I don't even have armor right now. So I'm going to do a little bit of research, now that I have all this stuff sort of up and running. And then, that's interesting. Oh, I guess it makes sense, because yeah, the green science is only in the second car. Huh, okay. Anyway, I'm going to do some research, catch up on the research, see if we can get some better weapons, and let's see if we can beat up some bad guys and sort of expand our boundaries a little bit. And I'll come back to you guys. So I made some armor. So I wanted to mess around with that. Oops. Alright, so what I want to do is I made... This is working. Right mouse to open. Okay, so there's... Oh, God. What did I just do? Oh. That's not what I wanted to do. When I have this on me, I have an expanded inventory. I clicked on the wrong thing. Hold on. Let's clean up the floor. Okay, try again. Oh, and this. I am doing pretty good today. But now they're gonna bring me a bunch more stuff. Because all this stuff came out of my inventory. Alright, let's... Okay, so how do I do this? I had to right mouse click. I left mouse clicked. So right mouse click to open up the inventory for the armor. Okay. And then I have different things. So I actually have a fusion, portal fusion reactor, which is going to be here. And then the other thing I want to definitely have is a personal drone thing. So this will give me drones in my inventory. They do... charging station. So I can have 10 drones in my inventory. So let's see. Can I... Yeah, so I can just make some now. So let's... I want them to be construction drones, I think. So I'm gonna make a bunch of construction drones while we play with the rest of our stuff. So right click on there. Okay. And then did I make some more stuff? Maybe not. Maybe that's all I made. Okay, that's all I made, I guess. Can alert for a bit. All right. Best to learn auto hotkey. Interesting. We also, I think, want to. While we're running around, we could make. This is what the other thing I want to make. So I need advanced engines to make that. So let's get some advanced engines so we can walk faster. That's what I was excited about. So yeah, while our drones are making, they'll be in our inventory, and then we can use those to do cool things. Actually, I guess I should... Once I walk into here, I'm no longer in the logical zone. So they won't drop off the engines to me. So I'd like some engines. What's your deal? Huh. What is the... That's weird. He was trying to build it on top of the thing. Okay. So I guess I won't wait for them to drop out of the stuff. I'll just get it later. So if you look here... While I'm working on building those, I'm having some issues here with this traffic. So I have I think I only have two trains that are dropping stuff off here. Let me not die. There we go. Two trains. One is ore. One is the coal. So what I kind of want to do is add a different exit. That's used for just the raw resources drop off. And I don't have any. Oh no, there we go. Okay, good. So let's get rid of some of these. And then we're going to make a different exit coming off of here. So probably something like here. We're going to have to loop back to this so we can come this way. Oh, one more. And then we'll have to remove some things. These guys will have to go. So then this should help out with a little bit with traffic. So once that guy clears, I'm going to change it so that they go this way instead. Oh, that's right. Now I have drones in my inventory. So now I just told it to like build those things. It's actually just stealing off from my inventory, which is not really what I wanted, but that's okay. So we'll take those out. So now if you're dropping off raw resources, you're only gonna leave this way instead. So then we can also add another light here just in case. Yeah, so they're gonna steal everything from my inventory now. So I have to keep that in mind. So let's make it so we have some of those on stock. Before I used to just be able to just tell it I want to build it and then I wouldn't have to worry as much about it. Okay, so this here. So now anything coming through here is going to here. So we don't really even need this other line for this new design. Interesting. Anyway, so that's a little bit better. So now the trains, there'll be two trains coming in here to drop off stuff, and then they leave that way. I mean, otherwise we have some other issues where these, can we speed these up at all? These, oh no, they don't have speed up things. So it's just a matter of having too much. Although if you look, these things are arriving full. So I really have, you know, an overabundance of copper anyway. So, right. So let's head up to this other one. Maybe we might do the same idea, possibly. So this is one where we're making steel. Although I don't think I have as many steel trains grabbing steel and then leaving. So we may have to not worry as much. Yeah, there's only two. So it's probably okay. I just have a lot of trains that grab copper and run around. Okay, so next I want to head on over to, I have up top I have a spot where I am trying to get there quick. Do I have those engines I wanted? I don't. Interesting. All right, maybe I'll go pick some up. I want to go to the place, the oil area up here. Actually, I guess to the left here. So let's avoid that train. Bring me some extra supplies. I believe in this here, I have a spot where I'm making a bunch of advanced, better engines. Oh, I seems wrong. There we go. Now they'll finish up that side. Okay, so up here, I think I have a spot where I'm making advanced engines, possibly. Yes, I'm using them all right away. I think they get made. Happy Factorio Friday. They get made. And they get, oh, so this grabs those, and this takes them and puts them directly into here. Okay. So if we just rotate this guy first for now, this guy, we can steal some advanced engines from here. Not really the best, but it might work. I might have had some advanced engines, but then I used them up for my drones. So that's one way I can get some. I possibly might be able to get some from another spot. We'll see. Let me clean up my inventory a little bit. But yeah, I've been busy. So how many did I need for that? Probably a lot. Yeah, 30. Okay, that'll take a while. So maybe we'll come back to this. I'll have to make a note to come back to this. I'll go like that. I don't know. We'll see if I remember. otherwise, right now I already have 1,052 construction drones. So I already have plenty running around. So I don't really have to worry about that. In fact, oh, here we go. We could just steal some for my inventory. For my my cool armor. Okay. So now that said, let's go. So if I tell them to, I always keep these in my inventory, and power lines, including those power lines, and then we actually don't need any of these anymore. Let's get rid of all those, free up some space. I was restructuring a couple things. That's why I have all these in my inventory right now. Okay, and these can go away. Okay. So, now, let's go expand. So I've expanded quite a bit already. and I have quite a large area. But I think I want to expand. If I expanded upward into here, then I would get another copper and iron spots. That seems like a good way to expand. I mean, I would like if there was oil and stuff, I would do it, but what? Beam works on Internet Explorer again. I don't know. I don't use Internet Explorer, I wouldn't know. So I guess I'll expand a little bit here first, and then I'll expand this all up. So let's go there first. Where's my guy? There he is. So we'll head on up to here, where I'll expand. So I was doing, so I have tanks I can use. Recently I've switched to just using, I don't want to get killed by this guy. Okay. So we don't need these. These are no longer working. Those are all done. These are done. Done. Okay. You can save on power if I remove them instead of keeping them around, not doing anything. All right, so we'll head on over this way. Actually, it looks like I could also expand. Like, what I've learned is that if I expand it in sort of a weird shape, if it's not sort of like a rectangle that I keep on expanding, then my drones fly over bad guy bases and they all die. So I've learned that I kind of have to do it all together. Also, if I didn't say it, welcome X-Ray. Alright, so we're going to remove these trees. And I guess maybe I didn't do that because of those guys. So let's head over there. So now that I have drones in my inventory, I think this should work. So here's a little, single power pole and lasers. So in theory, when I click this down, my guys will place them down. So that'll be easier than... Oh, they're actually repairing it too. Interesting. I guess I didn't really think that they would do that. So now I can go like this, and then walk out my defenses. Oh, the other thing. Now that I've been playing this one for so long that now the bad guys have evolved, like these the green guys, and so they're much tougher. You didn't say it. You were too busy mocking. Well, no, not really mocking your use of Internet Explorer. I'm just saying I have no experience with. Why aren't they building these? Huh? It's interesting that they're not. I have them. Why aren't they? Oh, it must be that somebody else is supplying that build request to other guys. So. I might have not been arranged, possibly. We'll see. But anyway, so this is a pretty... Now that I have these guys, it's pretty effective for... there we go. As long as I'm close enough. If I'm too far away, it... then that request gets filled by somebody else, looks like. Right, so this guy here, because I don't really don't want all that wood. Is there? Oh. So this is, so this point here, I'd have the intersection. So let's put the intersection in, plane it up, and then add the defenses on the top, and they'll build it off. Yes, there are huge bugs. I didn't welcome you at all. Are you sure, Ginger Bunsen? I think we should go back to the tape. Welcome, Ginger Bunsen. Okay, so now we have all of this we need to go after. So how is our supply of... Okay, so I've used up all of my... All my guys, it looks like. So all these are used up. Nope, that's not good. Okay, we're good now. Check the tape. What is the point of this game? So, the end game is that you you research far enough, get enough resources, build a rocket, and then launch it into space, and you beat the game. But meanwhile, like, you're trying to collect resources and build stuff. You can have tanks. And then meanwhile, on the planet, there's all these bugs. So these are like spawners, kind of. And so, as they are left alone, they produce bad guys. Over time, the bugs evolve some. So, the different colors are the difficulty. So, like, these red ones are the easier ones, and then blue, and then next up is these green guys, which even my laser turrets that can all be firing, it takes a while. So I can start taking over the world. So I need to get a bunch of... So I might actually tell the system to just give me, like, a lot of laser turrets. So let me move into the logical grid. So I have to be in this area, this orange area here, to get the stuff. Yes, I don't know. Yeah, I haven't really looked into the new update. So what I'm kind of thinking is that I'm near the point of beating this game. I think fairly soon I'm gonna beat this one, and then I'll be playing a new one, and I might try to go for certain achievements. Like, I won't try to certain things. Like, I don't know, like, I might not do trains, or I might not do drones, or I'll look at the different achievements, because there's somewhere there's a whole bunch of achievements. There we go. So I already have 50% of the achievements, but like, some of them are pretty tough. So, like, build a diesel within the first 90... Interesting. Okay. So, some of these... This is one that that Zizo's doing right now. At least, I don't know if he's already finished it or not, but he's posting those. So, you can do ones with no solid power. You can do no laser turrets. So, there's different achievements. So, I might try to work on some of these achievements. This is another... Yeah, there is no spoon. He's trying to work on that one, too. No, that one's pretty tough, it looks like. But... and then you can attach these... like, to the side, so you can, like, track or more following you. Wow, that's a lot of combat drones. Interesting. Okay. With fire. I'm not even sure how to do that one. So I might work on some of these achievements coming up, and then research all technologies. It seems like I should be able to do that. Right now I'm having a little bit of slowness with my technology tree, but I'm working on it. So I guess maybe before I beat this one, I'll do that one where I research everything. So do I have a whole lot of these laser turrets? Not yet. I'm still waiting on them to bring me more. I'm assuming that there are more in the system. Maybe not. Let's see. Can I see on this thing? I don't know how to... Like, if you look on the right, there's a list of stuff that's inside the logical system. But I can't see it all, and I can't scroll down. And also, I'm in the way of some of it. But, I don't know how to open up that interface in a way that's, like, easier to see. So, I don't know. Bonuses, map, trains. These are all my trains. have a couple of trains. So if we zoom in a little bit, we can see, like, see them all running around. Okay, so I must not have very many more turrets around, so I have to just sort of be, can't use them all up, I guess. So, do this, and then we can take these out. So they're taking them away, that's not really what I wanted. Oh well. And we go like this, and now we can, I can inch this forward. So this is, you know, one way of doing it. The other way is I had a tank, or I have a tank, that I would, like, use and then run around a whole bunch. Where, like, you know, I'd run in, beat some stuff up, run away, heal up, etc. Yeah, this is me. Yep. This is my dude. And there's the big, huge, ugly green guys that are doing a lot of damage. Hey, J. Cole. I like this playthrough design. Yes. Yeah, I like the grids, and as long as I space the grids out, or like the roundabouts, then I run into a lot less problems. So it works out pretty well. Those stupid green guys. But yeah, so I want to take this stuff out. Go away. Yeah, the green guys are really causing me problems. So will my guys automatically put in more repair those things? I guess maybe not. Not sure. No, okay, they did. So this is about colonizing an alien planet. Yeah, kind of. Like, see, I think you crash landed on this planet. And then your goal is to... I guess leave, actually, I think. I mean, you're colonizing it, but then your end goal is that you're trying to build a rocket and then fly away, I think. I don't know if you actually fly away in the rocket or not, but you're at least sending away a rocket, like a satellite. I forgot what the initial story was. Do you still drive the tank around much anymore? Yeah, I did for a while, but this is faster, I guess. So I've gone back to this design, because if I have the drones on me, then I don't have to worry about them flying over. So it works out pretty well. And then what I can do is I can remove some of the further back stuff. So if I just sort of, now that I have the drones, I can just walk around, and then they'll put it all back in my inventory. So let's actually build another data port. I'm assuming if I have another one of these, I can have even more drones flying around. That's my guess. Come here to destroy the... Right, exactly. No problem? No problem. Workers are welcome. Alright, I'm going to advance this a little more. Because if you don't advance too much, then they're still spawning in more guys. But yeah, so I'm not sure what my next playthrough exactly. I'll have to see what the new update is and see if that sort of inspires me of how I'm gonna handle the next playthrough. But I'll expand a little bit more, and then I'm on the verge of working on beating the game. I have some more technology I still have to do. But otherwise, hate to say it, it's. Okay, do we... Okay, no, there's a little bit more... Oh, these guys are the big guys. Yeah, this guy's actually producing the big guys. It's no good. Alright, let's work this over. Take out all the things. Looks like we're out of turrets, so let's remove some of the back ones. I'll have to walk within range so they can get it. They grab all the things, and then we can run back this way. And then now we're in range of this, and they'll put them down. Oh, we took it all out. Okay, good. So now, there's that, and then I wanted to expand this down this way. So let's actually just take all of this out that we just put in. We'll have to walk within range. A person is great. It's people that are the problem. Well, in this case, it's a person that's the problem for the aliens. Yeah. I'm destroying everything. Like when you're playing this at first, they don't really attack you, but it's when you start polluting and taking out trees and stuff like that that they don't want you around. So I'm just gonna have my drones pick up all the stuff. Once I get to the next data board thing, basket's the problem. I might try to grab some more construction drones. Especially if I'm building more data ports. So in theory, if I right click on this, I might be able to install another one in. So now I can have even more running around at one time. Cause I think I have 10, I think, per one of those things. So we'll see if that works. And then also remember that earlier in the episode, I turned off that one. They're charging up by me. I took out. Right. Let's grab half a stack. Here we go. There we go. That should be good. And then we can also. Right. We have another one already. Let's put another data port in. Put it here, I guess. Whatever. Cool. Now we're going to have more running around. Anyway, I can go pick up the. Oh, okay. Right. Sorry. Let these guys build stuff in the meantime. I can pick up the advanced motors. That's what I was trying to say. So now let's use our blueprints. Tell these guys to build. Like, usually, this is pretty far in the game, Max. So usually you have to build a lot of things, but I have, like, a bunch of different stuff that's building all these different components and stuff. And then I have blueprints that I can lay out designs. So these are just, like, plotting out stuff, and then I have drones that can, can come in and then actually like lay, you know, drop everything down. So you put in blueprints for where everything should be, save that design, and then you can plop in the design on the ground, and then as long as you're within the orange, if you're within the orange or green, or in this case, I have my own little radius, that then allows them to build stuff. But only if I have the inventory, only if I have this stuff on me. So that's why it sort of stopped. Now, we don't want to build too far over this way because I have base here and I'm trying to build here. So they might fly over the bad guy area. So we want to loop down here and advance this wall over a little more first. This is sort of what I've been doing a lot is, like, I'll be playing and then I need to clear out a little bit of area. And then we want to, here comes a couple of the big guys. So, I just can wipe out a whole forest. These guys, they actually die pretty fast against these, but against my laser turrets, they take a while. So let all the bad guys come in and die for a second. And then I will work on advancing our wall. And then these things are all like turrets basically that are pretty mean. I wonder if these ones have other bigger, like, these are the biggest ones, but how do you get enough stuff to make rockets? You have to mine up the resources, so like some of the stuff, let me put in a couple more turrets in here. And then I can run around a little bit. Okay. Where's my closest mine from here? Yeah, okay. I'll head on over to this. I have a copper mine. So around the ground, there's a bunch of resources. So we run over there. So, On the ground here, so like if we take this out, when you first come here, there'll be a patch of this stuff. So this is copper, and they had a certain amount. So you can sit here and mine it, collect the resources, and then you can use those to craft things. Well, you have to take the copper ore, smelt it, and then you have copper plates that you can use to craft stuff. And eventually, then you can make these little miners that will actually mine this stuff up for you. So now the miner's mining it up, moving along a conveyor belt, and then I'm moving it onto a train, which collects it. Why are you sitting here? Oh, inactivity. You should also... Time passes, 30 seconds. So then there's trains here that I have. So this whole network of trains, like all these things are train routes. And so this train is programmed to come here, pick up ore from the station, and then pick up ore either a little bit of inactivity time, 5 seconds, or 30 seconds of like just sitting here. And then after that, then he leaves, and then he drops that off somewhere else. And then I have another train doing the same thing. I'm adjusting the logic a little bit. There we go. Cat stepped on. Oh, no. Anyway, so if you look at the tech tree, this is the technology for actually doing the rocket. So I need to research all of this first. So all the red or yellow stuff I have to research still. Also this guy. And I have to build a bunch of stuff. So I have to get a bunch of concrete. I need to build a bunch of different components, rockets and stuff. It takes a long time. So it's sort of a long process. Although there's an achievement to do it all the whole game in 8 hours. But like this particular one, maybe there's a way where I can see how long I've been playing this particular one. I don't know. There might be a way. But I've been playing this one for a while. Let's expand this base out a little bit more. And then we could potentially expand upward. The tank is fun. But you have to do a lot of like running. Oh, actually, I'm wondering how the tank works with my drones. Maybe we'll try that out. So we'll put in our ammunition and our fuel and all that stuff. I also want to get rid of all of this wood. So let's make the wood disappear. So I put the wood in that section down here, which says get rid of all that. So here's a bunch of drones that are gonna fly in, empty up my inventory of all the things. Okay, that's good. So I'll pop in the tank and drive. So we'll see if the guy that's having inventory will actually fix it up. I want to use this weapon for now. Okay, so they do pop out and repair it, I think. Interesting. Or what are they doing? Or they're chopping down trees. Huh. So they didn't repair it, but I wonder if I pop out if they will repair it. We'll see. I don't want this guy to be by me. Okay. One thing that these guys, if you stop and they're... my guys are actually... They're running around chopping down trees. It's kind of funny. So, if this thing blows up, then I lose all the stuff inside of it. So let me stop for a second. And what I'm guessing is if I pop out... Oh, no, that's interesting. I thought maybe... Well, that other guy's repairing it. Oh, I also don't have any repair kits. Okay, let me get repair kits. Oh no, I do have repair kits as a requested thing. Interesting. But I don't have any. Let me see if I can get them to bring me some. That's weird. But yeah, so I have a tank. So if I play this, when I play this again and I come up with a new design, I'm probably going to, like, this thing doesn't really work out very well with like tanks and cars. Like, there's these gates, but it's really hard to get this tank through the gate. Technically fits, but you have to run into the wall a lot. And then if I'm cruising along, I'll have to like weave around this stuff. And so if I come up with a new design, I'll probably have larger gates on the insides here, and then offset it so that I can actually get around and like get past everything better. So I like the trains, how they work on this fairly well. But I want to be able to run around in the cars and stuff like that. So that'll be one adjustment I'd make in the new design. I'm hoping that they're bringing me repair kits. Otherwise, I could probably make some, actually. Yeah, okay, I could just make some. Okay, repair kits, good. So let's go ahead and hop in the tank. So they're repairing all that stuff, which I guess is good, too. So, yeah, I really like this armor. I should probably get this sooner or next time. Because having this armor and having these drones like live on me, where they can take the stuff from inside of me and then like make the repair stuff and build defenses and everything, it's nice. All right, hop in. We'll go beat up some stuff. But like, so some of these things you can't really. Okay, so he is trying to, I think, repair me possibly, or he's just coming back to me. I'm not sure. The drones are your... Yes. Exactly. Okay, that guy is not very nice. They're kind of beating up all my stuff. What a jerk. Here, oh, he's dead. Okay. Alright, so they do repair me. Okay, cool. But yeah, if I stop moving... there's problems sometimes where they'll get me stuck. Like they'll basically surround me. But this actually isn't too bad with the drones on me. I mean, they're destroying everything, which is kind of a pain. So let's destroy some buildings. Don't get too close to that guy. We're running over trees pretty well. Alright, we'll stop here, next to all of our defenses. I will also work on expanding this out a little bit. So I can plot it out here, I'm not within range, but then when I drive by it, it'll build it in. Alright, let's go run over there. Alright, we'll cruise on down here. Oh dear, oh dear, oh no, oh it's a problem, I'm stuck. Run away! Yeah, okay. So if you let them corner you, you're in trouble. Because these guys, you can run over these guys a little easier, the spitters, but the actual melee guys, they're pretty durable. They're hard to get around. So let's re-put this stuff back in. Alright, and then we are making a bunch of repair stuff already. Okay. Alright, let's cruise on back out there. Let these guys build in the turrets and everything. Make sure we're on the right weapon. Okay, we still have to re-destroy this guy. Yeah, these drones being with me is really sweet. Definitely. So let's let my dudes repair all that stuff. The other cool thing that's cool about the tanks and stuff is that they have this inventory. So you can actually use this like to bring stuff around. So you could like run over to somewhere far away, grab some supplies, and then come back. So it's pretty cool. Okay. One more gun. So I don't really have to necessarily expand this far. Well, I guess if I were to, so that whole base ideally would be gone so that it's one straight line going up. But I really like them repairing the tank because it saves me a lot of time. Oh, now I ran into the green guys again. How far back is it again? Is it the same spot again? Oh man, there's an autosave. I should have. It's a pain. So I guess, I mean, another option is if I were to, so I could shoot them. This isn't gonna work out well.
Oh no. Ooh, run away. Run. Oh, stop shooting me.
Yes, repair me. That was close. That was a close one. Yeah, so this is the game. It's fun. And there's like, this is like way far into the game. So there's like a lot of like figuring out how the game works before this. I'm pretty far in. Alright, let's go beat up some stuff, try to... Alright, just spitters. Alright, so we took out one place, so that's less dudes that will appear. These guys, the melee guys are a big problem. And I guess we could also expand out. Oh, I didn't want you to use it, my guy. Oh, pain in the butt. I mean, I guess that's good, but... Now, so now I'm in the logical network, so they'll actually bring me more supplies back whenever I'm in this area. Which is nice. Alright. So three, expand this out. This time, don't die. Good. And we will make sure I have the right gun selected. Avoid getting stopped by that guy. Am I out of turrets? How come you guys didn't build that stuff? Oh, I guess this is inside the build area. Okay. So if I'm not next to that, the request to build that will be from somebody else. So some other drone that's far away might get that request. So it's not as quick if I'm actually within the regular build area. Okay. A little bit more gun. Let's do a drive-by down here. Guy grabbed it instead. So it also took a while to practice this tank driving. Like trying to turn at the right point so that you get near your stuff, but not too near your stuff. Turn. So yeah, with these guys, I can actually get up pretty quick again and then beat up more guys. And then what else is coming up? Oh god, turn. So usually I wouldn't have all this. So when I was actually doing this, I'd run all the way back here, and then these are all like regular. These are lasers, and then these guys are use bullets. But yeah. Anyway. So I don't know what I want to do. Like I feel like I've sort of beaten this one. I mean, I haven't actually finished it yet. I have to still get the technology and everything. But I feel like I've already accomplished what I want to. I think probably on this map. So I will work my way over towards beating it once I... Technology is going a little slow. Let me take a look at that, possibly. You guys are only attacked after you started using resources. That means... Yes, right. No, I know. Yeah, I mean, I'm an invader on their planet. I don't know how to talk to them. I'd be like, hey, I'm trying to get off the planet. Can you just let me go? Oh no, this is bad. This was a bad idea. This was a horrible idea. I was gonna try and cut through. Oh, this might. No. There's a bunch of. Oh dear. This isn't gonna work. Okay. Never mind. Here, load to wherever I was last. In the middle of combat. Okay. Let's return. So I will. I guess I'll walk there manually. I want to try and get my science. So that's what then we can work on. I'm going to try to get my science working better. So let's find out. I'm assuming, I think blue science is what I'm short on. So we can actually potentially, yeah, okay. Let's get a little faster. So we can create a train real quick. Pop on the train. Tell it to go to blue science pickup until time passes. And all right, I'll let them bring me some stuff. Okay, good enough. Time passes, manual go. So now this guy, I've just programmed him to go to a particular destination. So I have one spot where I'm making blue science. And so this guy's on his way there. That was a weird way of going around that one intersection. So here's where the blue science is. And so this is, I think, our bottleneck. So we're actually going to remove that. So this is where we're making the blue science. And if we notice, there's not really a surplus. Like, let's see. So there's the green and red train. He's fine. And then waiting for the other train to come by. They're bringing me a lot of stuff. Anyway, we can look to see what we're missing. So if we look at these, it looks like it's actually the red. The red chips is what we're short on. So we need to figure out where the red chips come from. So if we click on this, we can see here's the trains that come in. So this one is red chip pickup. And then it comes here. So we want this train to come to where we are now. And we can try to see why the red chip place is being slow. So I will wait here. I mean, there's a little bit of blue science coming through. I could see how much there was in that one. But anyway, so the red chip drop off is on his way. And then we can hop on that and then follow that back to... so here he is here. On his way. That's the wrong one. That's for the other thing. So we'll let that one just do its thing. And all these little things you program. Not program, but you put them in and that makes it so the trains don't collide. Alright, batteries. Where are you? Blue science mat drop off. It might be him there. Alright. Are you... Yes. Alright, so I'll hop on the train, tell it to go to blue chip pickup. Whoa! Thank you for the follow. Elric M. So now we're heading over to where blue chips are being created. I'm sorry, blue chips. Red chips. Where red chips are being created, and then figure out why it's being slow. Eventually, the evil basket defeated by Quintistics. Okay, so this is where red chips are created. So there are some. Not a lot. So let's look to see what the bottleneck is here. So it looks like plastic, but we'll take a look. Yeah, so plastic. So now we come here. Oh, I almost got run over. That's exciting. So this guy, the plastic drop-off. Actually, we may not have... How is the plastic working here? So this is green chips. This is copper, I think, right? Yeah, copper. And then plastic. Okay, so this guy is plastic pickup drop off. Is this him right here? Yeah. So it's just sort of a bottleneck with plastic. Interesting. So we need to... Need to get more plastic going. I stepped away to make a sandwich return. Well, the consensus is that these are intelligent beings and I'm destroying their planet. Which is true. Okay, so here is where we're making plastic for those red ships. So yeah, there's a little bit of a bottleneck here. I think I actually have a bunch more plastic in a different spot. So it's possible I could hook a rail into that and they could pick it up from both places. So let's work on that. So right, this is where I am right now. I also then am doing plastic here. I think. But I'm using it straight up for blue chips, but I might have extra that I could use. So let's try and get down there. So I want to get to blue chip mat drop off. It'll be the fastest way to get there. So I'll just come over here. Try not to get run over. Oh god. I put down my temporary train right when this other train was coming through. Alright, let me come over here. Oh, and actually this thing should have some more lights in here. Interesting. There. Okay. So let's try it again. We'll give this guy some fuel. We wanted to go to so blue chip mat drop off is where we want to go. Right? I think so, yeah. And then go. So once we get there, I'm gonna try to take excess plastic from that and then drop it off the other thing. So I just got a supplemental from I think for the most part I've fixed all my traffic jams I was getting before. So that's good. Alright, here is the where I'm making blue chips. So here I drop off these three resources. And then I'm mining up oil here. It comes in, I refine it. Or I'm sorry, I refine this. Comes up with three resources. I break it down even further, and I end up with these other stuff. So here actually, okay, so here's an example. So here I'm actually, I have some from just logical network. So how much do I have in logical network? I can't tell. Interesting. And then here I'm making more than I need. So I think actually what I should do is remove this. And then, let's see. So it's here. How is your oil? This spot doesn't have a whole lot of oil. I have five here, which is sort of my first area here. But then I've since gotten a whole bunch over here. I'm using that for both batteries and plastic. So there's a bunch here, but then otherwise, and I also have like two down here. But I haven't otherwise found like any more anywhere. I was hoping there's gonna be another big patch that came up, but so far nothing. All right, so what I want to do is get this plastic out of here in some way. Let's see. I guess the other thing I could do, it seems like I do have some in the logical network. So if I don't bring it here, I could bring it over there instead. I don't know how much I have in there. So have you played this much? Elric M? Do you know, is there a way where I can, like, look at my logical network to find out how much of a certain thing I have in there? Okay, wait, I think I almost can see it. I'm guessing I have 770-something. 74, maybe. You can't quite see it. If I go like this, it's slightly visible. So, we can use those. I can use combinators. Reading the content from a... Interesting. What is this technology? Maybe I haven't researched that part yet. Yes, I have not. Okay, well, so there's something else I haven't done in the game at all. Is this thing. So let's research this instead. And we get to play with this toy. That's one thing. I've done. I think I've done almost everything in the game except for that. See you, Max. Thanks for stopping by. Okay, so now I have this. So there's red wires, blue wires, arithmetic combinator, decider combinator, constant combinator, and power switch. Use to control the connections of an electrical network can also be controlled by the circuit network. I know nothing, John Snow. Let's do, did you have a suggestion which one I should use? Let's get me started on how this works. So I will make some wires. Okay, done. I will make a decider. Alright, I just wanted one. I'll make a decider. And then let's see how that works. So I'll wire that up to this and we'll see what happens. Because I think these guys will probably be able to keep up with this, possibly. We already have 1.2k blue chips, so we already have plenty of blue chips. So I just need more red chips. Which I guess I could also keep the excess red chips. Although right now I don't have excess. Once this thing is full, anyway, whatever. So now we have a thing. So we have some red wire. Okay, we clicked on this thing. All right, so that connects two things together. So let's put down this thing. Give it some power. We can tell it stuff. Okay, I'm listening. What does this do? Decider. So input, output. Signals. Wow. Okay. It just takes an input and gives an output. Well, I guess we have a wire. There are ways to program your factory to do things. I'm intrigued. Let's attach this wire from here to there. So now they have, now it has a little wire box. Isn't that cool? So input. Okay, so math, cool. So if you connect the red wire from the thing to the, okay, I did that. Then I can say plastic. If it's greater than zero. Interesting. Output. A signal. Copy the count of a specified output signal from the input. Okay, sure. That gives you an output. Okay, so I have this thing. Go. So potentially this will say if the plastic in this is greater than zero, output. Output the number. You can use plastic if you wish or any other signal type. So where does it output the number? Output the specified output signal with a value of 1. Just click on any signal to activate it. What's this? Mode of operation. Read logical network contents. Oh, interesting. Okay, so I can switch which one it does. Mouse over it. Oh. Well, I can see how much I have now. Okay. Interesting, I think. Let's remove that here. No. This seems like it's probably cool, but I'm confused. Let me spin up the game a moment. Yeah, this is one thing I was gonna play with at some point, I just haven't gotten around to it yet. So you can, like, hook up stuff to stuff. Alright, let's make some other things. So we have arithmetic, constant combinator, and a power switch. More toys. So arithmetic. Oh, detach. Okay, I detached it. So what does this do? So same idea. Oh, arithmetic. Okay, I gotcha. Okay. I think I want to go back to this. Let's look at the constant combinator. I have no idea. Let's hook it up. it's now hooked up. Do we know when? I have no idea. I haven't actually looked into it at all. I'm not sure. Very interesting. Well, I mean, this one at least adjusted my UI a little bit so I can see. Yeah, it's my amount went up. So where am I making it that I'm storing excess? That's cool. Alright, well, I guess I was going to move it by train, but I guess if it's being made somewhere and being put on the logical network, I could just have him fly it. So I'll take this back. Although it looks like I am actually short here. Interesting. Okay, maybe I'll put it back. So requester chest. This guy goes here. You are plastic. The downside, though, here is that when I do that, it's filling up the space and making it so that these guys don't produce. So that's what I want to avoid. So can I rearrange this so that those will produce first? Probably. I mean, not as compact as I have it. But like if this requester chest was an in-between step in here. If we go, let's take this one out. Give us a little bit of extra room to play with. And then if I go like this, I can put the requester chest. Oh, I can't move. Take this out. Put the requester chest here. And then these guys here. So this is for the, I want at least 100 plastic bars in here. I was gonna put it on the wrong side though. Okay, we can move this one up. There we go. A little more room. So this guy's here. No, that didn't help. This guy's here. Like this. Requester chest. 100 plastic. Output. That we can move. Oh, we can actually just go like that. There we go. Now it's on the correct side. And we need one more thing here. And some power. And then this one will just output directly on there. So this one will potentially not be used if this is filled up over here. But now this thing here will pull in logical network stuff if it hasn't already been filled up by these guys, by these three. And then it is in the right space. So here they come bringing in more. So where's that coming from? Well, that could just be general storage, it's hard to say. I'm not sure where I'm actually making extra plastic. But, so I can do that here. Looks like I don't actually have extra red here, so let's go over to that red, the blue science area. I don't really know how these things work. I'll have to come back to that. I'll grab them for now and come back to that idea of checking those out. Let's go ahead and go to blue chips. We will want a requester chest eventually. Where's my automotive? There we go. Blue chip. We have fuel already good. Blue chip mat. No, I'm sorry. Blue science. No, it's not even right either. I want to go to red chip pickup. Get in the train and go. There's a lot of red chips there. We're just using up so much for science. Oh, actually, speaking of which, let's go back to researching science. So we're on our way here. So let's just start researching all kinds of things. Okay, here is the red chip area. So we can get rid of this train. And what we can do is we can make this chest just be a requester chest. So this thing's gonna drop off plastic, but it's not, there's not a lot of plastic coming in. And so this will also grab it from the logical network. So it'll probably empty out the logical network, I guess is. Because there's a lot of red chips that I need to pick up. But that'll make them all pretty quick and it'll be good. But yeah, so I'm gonna research a bunch more, potentially, next episode, I will work on trying to beat it, maybe. And then that way, I'll be closer to when the new update coming out, and I can decide, you know, what is season 3. And then I can also potentially play around with. I might look up some videos on the wiring and you know, comparators or whatever they're called. What are these things called? These things. Combiners. So I might research this a little bit, see how they work, see if that inspires me on some project, but otherwise I'll work on beating this, playing what season 3 will be, maybe even just getting achievements or scenarios or whatever. But yeah, that'll be the end of the stream. Thank you everybody for coming. Oh, I missed the camera.